when Saturn plus Ketu conjunction, you have it in the birth chart, what will happen? Okay, so as I mentioned to you, when these two planets comes into the conjunction, as Saturn represents the career, you'll be having a lot of career breaks. This person will be taking a lot of really lot of career breaks, professional breaks will be there. For example, first 2 to 3 years he'll be working in one profession, and later he'll be taking few months of rest, and later again he will get into another profession. Or sometimes he will get dissatisfaction towards the career and he will get terminated from the organization, and again he will join to somewhere else after taking certain break. So there'll be a professional breaks all the time. And this person also will be moving from location to location. Let's say if you have it in the 12th house or in the 4th house, okay, this person will be keep changing the location. For example, 4 years he will stay in Hyderabad, 4 years he will stay in Chennai, and 4 years he will stay in Bombay. There'll be a lot of transfers and change of location happens. Okay, and these people are little very confused in nature as well. They are very, they lack a certain direction in their life, because Ketu is a planet doesn't like to listen from others. It's a very stubborn planet. When Saturn joins with Ketu, this makes the person especially very stubborn. He doesn't like to listen to others. They like to break the rules. They like to lead the life in whichever way they want. And most importantly, what I notice, especially if Saturn plus Ketu conjunction, you have it in the 7th house or in the 1st house, this person not even care for other people, feelings or emotions. Especially in the Ketu planet period, they're they just give damn for other people, feelings and emotions. They just like to talk in whichever way they want, and they don't like to. In fact, you might have come across such kind of people with this kind of attitude and all that. Okay, and also Saturn represents the karmic planet. Okay, so when Ketu joins, this person will be undergoing a lot of luxuries in the first half of the life. In the second half of the life, he will realize that that is not the purpose of life, and these people will be going into the pathway of spirituality and enlightenment. These people will try to understand what exactly is the purpose of the life, because this is more of like a sannyasi yoga. This is considered, as per the Vedic astrology, this is considered as sannyasi yoga. That means the person will undergo all the materialistic pleasures, and later he will get into spirituality, and he will just keep continuing with that kind of spirituality nature. Okay, this happens especially you have Saturn plus Ketu conjunction in the 12th house, because 12th house is the house of spirituality, enlightenment. Okay, this person will be getting into too much into spiritual, falling, understanding the meaning of the life, going into the pathway of God, you know, following the religious speakers, religious leaders and all that. This, especially in the Ketu Mahadasha, Ketu Antradasha, the effect is seen a lot. Okay, let's say Saturn plus Ketu conjunction, you have it in the second house. Then, as I mentioned to you, this person is a little harsh in nature. The way they talk, it sounds very direct in the nature, very boldly they speak. As I mentioned to you, they will not be caring about what others think of themselves. They'll just speak, because Saturn is a stubborn planet. Ketu is the planet of confusion, impulsive nature. So they do not know what they'll be talking at what point of time. Let's say Saturn and Ketu conjunction, you have it in the third house. Okay, this person communication will not be that great enough. So if naturally learning the languages will become very tough for this person.